Hello and welcome to YouTube Developers Live. We have an exciting show for you today. Let me introduce our hosts and guests. My name is Jarek Wilkiewicz. In the studio, I have Jeremy Walker.
Hello.
How are you doing, Jeremy?
I'm doing well.
I heard you got a lot of sleep last night.
I did.
You do seem very perky. I think you can hardly sit in your chair.
I can't.
All right. Well, we have to restrain you then for the rest of the show. And then our distinguished guests from Telly. On my left, I have Evelio Tarazona. Yeah. How are you doing?
Good.
Thank you very much for visiting us this morning. I was told that you guys had pretty bad traffic on 101 here in Silicon Valley coming down from San Francisco.
Well, it wasn't that bad, but I mean, we are here. That is
cool. And then Adil Alani, who's the co-founder and CTO. How are you doing, Adil?
Great. Happy to be here.
All right. So let's talk about Telly. What we would like to learn is, you know, how did you come up with the idea? What is the problem you're trying to solve? And then I understand you came with a cool demo for us to see. So we would like to see some demos later on as well.
Sure.
So tell us, how did you come up with the idea of Telly?
So the idea for Telly actually came out of frustration that my co-founder and I were facing. And I think this is a frustration that a lot of people face, is that I'm bored and I want to watch some cool videos. Mm-hmm. And finding...
like this one, for example.
yeah. just finding cool videos to watch and, you know, for the right moment is actually pretty difficult. Unless you know exactly what to search for, there are just too many videos out there. You don't know which one to click on. And that's the problem we're trying to solve.
Mm-hmm. Great. And then you guys were working on TwitVid before this, right? So is TwitVid still going on? I mean, what's the relationship between that and your Discovery app?
Yeah, sure. So TwitVid is still alive. Mm-hmm. Our TwitVid apps are still strong on Android and iPhone. And Telly is an expansion beyond TwitVid. Mm-hmm. Really trying to solve the problem of video discovery. Mm-hmm. Whereas TwitVid was more of how do I share a video easily on Twitter or even on Facebook.
Mm-hmm. So you seem to be very focused on video.
Yes.
But a small pivot towards discovery with Telly.
Yeah, trying to address a new use case.
Okay, great. And then you said that the inspiration for the product came out of boredom.
Yeah, pretty much.
We don't hear that very often.
ever since the beginning, my co-founder and I have been really passionate about video and just being able to share videos and also being able to watch cool videos. And this is something that we've been working on for nearly 3 to 4 years now. Mm-hmm. So we just love the video space. And we think now this year is going to be the big year for video, mm-hmm. Especially for mobile video because of LTE.
Yeah.
And all these smartphones getting amazing cameras.
Great, right. So without further ado, could you show us a little demo about show us how the app works? And I understand you have a web version as well as the mobile version.
Sure.
I think you guys brought in some cool screenshots of the mobile app so we can see kind of the highlights. So why don't we try to do that?
Sure. So as you can see, this is telly.com. And essentially, what we're trying to do over here is trying to get rid of all the noise and really just focus in on the main, on the video that you're watching. And the videos that are shown to you are suggested or recommended by your friends. So over here, it tells me that my close friends, Apurva and Evan, are recommending this Boston crazy mode video. So I can click here, watch it, and it should be something that's fairly interesting and something I should probably really like because my friends also like it. Mm-hmm. Then, if I'm tired of this video, I can just hit next and move to the next video. In this case, this is a video that Telly has recommended for me based on my viewing habits, based on what I like, based on many signals. This next video, again, is another video that close friends liked as well. So essentially, when you go to Telly, you are discovering videos from your friends that are recommended. And also, at the same time, you're discovering popular videos as well. So I can click popular. And these are videos shared by the Telly community. These are handpicked today's funniest videos, pretty much. And you just swift through.
I got sucked into this the other day. I was telling you before the show got started.
Yeah, what we noticed with this is actually a newer version of the site. And before, we used to have a feed style, and you know, kind of like Facebook. Mm-hmm. With this new UI, we noticed almost triple the amount of time spent immediately overnight. Mm-hmm. So it shows that people are more engaged in this experience. Now, at the same time, this is where we kind of use the YouTube API in some interesting ways. We have a really cool way of searching for videos. So let's say I really like Armin van Buuren. So it's a trans DJ. So I'll type in Armin van Buuren here. And you can see that the autocomplete is showing me the top videos from Armin. And so I can just narrow down and say, okay, this is the, actually I want to listen to the top video here. So I just click on it and it'll start playing that video. The other videos in the search results are actually related to the first video that I just clicked on. So we pretty much got to the core of what people want to do, which is just watch videos and serendipitously discover them. Mm-hmm.
Great, and then you also have a mobile app,
yes.
Right? Is that something that has launched recently?
Our Android app has been in the market now for a few months, uh-huh. And it's doing really well.
Yeah.
So I'll bring up the Android app, and I'll let Avilio. Oops.
Don't disconnect the cable.
I disconnected the cable. Oops.
These are going to be screen. Oh, it doesn't like it.
All right, you can tell me what screenshot is
there. Feed.
All right. And in the feed, we've been working like hardly to aggregate the best videos for you, like what matters to you, like your friends that watch or like certain video. On Android, we take advantage of the YouTube library, the mm-hmm. player library. And I remember like last year was a hard journey, like trying to work with the HTML5 player yep. of YouTube. So our CEO just emailed, I think it was you, mm-hmm. or someone in the YouTube developer relationships. And I don't know, like somehow like they come with this player and we were like, wow, this is great because yep. It was really, really a pain in the ass. To,
yes, you know. For those of you watching who are not familiar with it, we have recently launched the YouTube Android Player API. This is something that we announced late December. And actually, Telly was one of the trusted testers for the API before we launched. So we got a lot of good feedback from you guys and a yeah. few bug reports that we managed to fix before the launch.
Yeah, so after, in your feed, you get like all the rich content, whatever it's like the Tweetbit videos. You can also get Vimeo videos yet. Well, in mobile, we're working to support them. And right now, we use HTML5 player, but hopefully someday also, like we're gonna get like all the players native. And for Telly, we use our own player. It's pretty much it's just a regular video view with some customization mm-hmm. on top of it. If we go further in the screenshot demo, we.
So now it's suggested friends.
Okay, so for so Telly is a social video network. So we focus on like you being able to find your friends and not only like your Twitter or Facebook friends, but also to discover new people. So we try to suggest to like the top users we have and also like people that you might be interested in following so you can get richer content in your feed.
Your profile and
well, in your profile, you find your mostly like the videos you had like or uploaded to Telly now, but also you can like find information like your regular profile is not much that
in the creation.
Well, we are that's pretty cool. We've been working really hard to match our iOS efforts in the creation. Sides, we're trying to bring the cool filters we have in iOS So far, we have managed to put really, really good filters. It's looking great. Hopefully, soon we can, you know, launch them on Android. Hopefully, taking advantage of the new APIs in Jelly Bean for media. So stay tuned for it. keep the app installed. Keep checking for new updates, and we will bring new filters.
So the app will allow you to both consume content as well as create content, right?
Yeah.
So this
yeah.
is kind of the Twitvid legacy continuing without within Telly.
But with a little bit more, with more tools to create better videos, actually. And then there's also music.
So one of the points of having like good creation tools beyond like just taking the video, we want to focus also like have a great tool to you to edit your videos. So like background music is one of the cool things you can do with the app. You can add music to your videos, and you can like tune it up, whatever, if you want to be like the audio is just the song, or you can also like put in something in the middle so you get like whatever the noise or your voice is on the video, but also the music, mix it up for you. We are looking forward to also like to create better tools. We have a full roadmap of awesome tools for video editing. You know, video editing is one of the like hard, it's a hard task, right?
Yeah.
I mean, like you, myself, I found very many times really, really frustrated with the video editing tools. So we are trying to offer you like a mobile app and solutions and tools so you can like easily create really, really beautiful videos.
Yeah, we spent quite a few hours editing these types of videos sometimes. Great. I know Jeremy had a bunch of questions about how you guys implemented the application.
Yeah, so I usually like to get into the technical section, and I wanted to talk to you a little about, well, actually, let's just get started. How did you implement Telly with the YouTube APIs?
Sure. So for every video that's being shared in your social graph, Telly is sucking it in. So we are pulling in all the videos that your friends are sharing, pretty much. And when we pull in a video, we're making a call to YouTube's API, if it's a YouTube video, to really get some metadata on the video, to understand if it's a mobile video, if it's playable on mobile or not, if it's embeddable or not, what are the tags behind the video so we can properly understand it. And that's important to us because we want to serve you the right video for the right situation. So for example, if you're on your mobile phone, we'll serve you only YouTube videos that are playable on mobile. We'll hide all the ones that can't play on mobile. Whereas if you're on your laptop, we'll show you only the videos that are embeddable by YouTube. So that's one area that we really use the YouTube API. Second area is in the player itself, our player integration, mm-hmm. and especially with the Android device using the YouTube SDK.
Okay. Well, what do you guys use on the back end, like language-wise?
It's a combination of Node.js and PHP.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So it sounds like you're using the data API and the iframe embed player,
yes.
Player API and then the Android player API.
Yeah.
Have you guys tried out the new version 3 of the data API yet?
Yep. We actually had a cool experience with it. I can share a little story. So we had about, I don't know, 5 million plus videos that we had to get the latest metadata for. Making 5 million calls to YouTube's V3 API in one day, you'll rate limit us. So what we ended up doing was we set up a cluster of servers on EC2, probably hundreds of servers, and they were all making calls to YouTube's API just so that we can get around the rate limit and get the information in one day. So we did a little bit of hacking to to play around and, you know, pull in some data.
Okay, cool. Is there anything that surprised you about working with the APIs? Do you guys?
Well, in the Android side, we had this interesting issue with in the early stages with the library. We had seen like some black rectangles around, I think it was because we were using a surface view, then mm-hmm. we changed for new APIs like surface texture, texture view, and we eliminated those black rectangles. It was much fun because if you like take a screenshot of the device, you don't get anything. You get just a regular screenshot, but it's on the display, and so you don't have a clue about. And hopefully you guys manage to resolve this issue.
Yeah. I think for the first release, we don't have that support. This is something that is being considered precisely for this type of use case.
Yeah, because in our initial feed, we were trying to bring like the inline playback you get in web, mm-hmm. like you can like scroll and you have the video playing on it. But we ran into some issues with the 2.x version of Android, so. With four Ice Cream Sandwich and app is a better experience in this way. We will try to bring it back. Right now, we use as you see in the screenshots, we use a view itself, like it's fixed. So mm-hmm. hopefully someday we can like bring the cool experience with hopefully Copper Flow too, you know, the carousel. And so
nice.
We're looking forward to that.
Cool. Well, do you have any? Anything on your wish list that you'd like to have in the API?
Yeah, actually, two big things on my wish list, at least. I'm sure they have some too. One is a YouTube player SDK for iPhone, mm-hmm. just like you did for Android. And the second one is if YouTube could ping us when a video has changed. State almost, because some videos get taken down for copyright infringement, and some videos one day they're mobile friendly, the next day they're not. So if we always have to find out by asking YouTube API yeah. all the time. If YouTube's API can just ping us, that'd be, I think, a cleaner solution.
Okay. Yeah, we were just talking about that yesterday with Jeremy.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, obviously, both issues come up. I would say the you know, fire hose type of approach is something that we've been hearing about from developers for quite some time. Yeah. So great. All right, so should we look into our moderator to see what questions we got?
Yeah, sure. So it looks like we have a couple. So. Actually, this is about the Telly mobile app, and they want to know if you can fling it to Google TV, if that's coming anytime soon.
We are definitely looking forward to working on Google TV. Like we've seen, like there is a big place for us to offer like discovery in your TV, and especially Google TV is like a good opportunity to get into. So far, like the not actually inconvenience are like preventing us. But right now we are like moving first like from smartphones to tablets. Mm-hmm. Once we have support for tablets, it's gonna be much easier to support Google TV. But we definitely want to support Google TV because it's an amazing experience you get in your TV.
For those of you watching, actually, we have recently launched the YouTube Android Player API on Google TV as well. So in December, we had the mobile experience. And then just a couple of weeks ago, we launched the Google TV support. So if you're building a Google TV application, let us know, because we're looking for a couple of them to feature.
Yeah,
definitely.
And then, of course, is YouTube developer relations hiring?
Is that question addressed to me?
It is.
I think so. So yes, we are hiring. In fact, if you would like to learn more, go to developers.google.com/jobs, and you'll see the job descriptions of the positions that are open. And the larger Google Developer Relations team is also hiring.
Yep. Great. Well, that's all we have.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your time and driving down here from the beautiful city of San Francisco. It was really fun hosting you. And thank you for giving us all the great feedback about the APIs.
Great.
Thank you very much for having us.
Thank you. And for those of you watching, we'll see you again next week, Wednesday, 10 a.m. Pacific. Bye.